Hi, honey.
You're mighty chipper this morning.
Oh, why shouldn't I be? Got my old job back. Oh, I can't wait to get back out to sea.
I'm so proud of you. I made you a big breakfast. Dig in.
Great. Listen, honey, I just want you to know I think it's wonderful the way you stuck by me through this whole thing.
Well, I stuck by you, Sam, because I believe in you. I know you. Oh, they made you out to look like such a klutz, such a moron. The media really took advantage of you. After all, it wasn't your fault that your tanker hit that reef and leaked all that oil. Just because you're the captain doesn't mean you should be responsible for every little thing that happens to your ship. And when the tanker did start leaking, well, the company did just what they were supposed to do. They laid down a containment boom. That's what any rational group would do. How are they supposed to know the spill was too big to be contained? They were just doing what they thought was right. So they did the next logical thing.
What was that?
They poured absorbent material on the spill to soak it up. Are you okay, honey?
Yeah. Just getting the coffee.
Yeah, that absorbent material was a great idea. Just made a bigger mess. And they really turned the tide when they decided to burn it off. That was brilliant. Sometimes that's the only thing that'll work. It's the cleansing power of flame. You just have to burn off what you can and let Mother Nature take care of the rest through evaporation. Hell's bells, in 100 years or so, they'll never know there was a silly little spill at all.
No, I think you're right, hon. We did good.
You sure did. I'm so proud of you, Sam. Goodness, look at the time. There's a fresh tanker of crude in the harbor, mister, and it's got your name on it.
I love you. Bye.
Don't forget your lunch.
Oh, yeah. Got it.
Coming this fall, it's the Exxon family.
Nobody's perfect.